Hey, Wethead, my boy Robert here. Today we're going to show you how to take the impeller off the Hayward power flow pump and how to access the seal. If you have the Hayward power flow pump in your backyard and you've been told that you need a new seal and you need to change it, we're going to show you how to do that today. Right?
Yep.
All right, so that's what we're going to do. So we're going to need a few tools, right? Robert has laid those out for us. We're going to need, what is this, Robert?
A hammer.
And we're going to need some flathead screwdrivers in a couple different sizes. We got a big one here, a little bit smaller. We have a nut driver here, which is a quarter inch in size, and a little small screwdriver. Okay, so basically what we're going to do is the first thing you want to do is remove the little clip here in the center of your pump, just like that. That will allow you to turn the volute back and forth, side to side, just like this. Okay, now you see there's a bunch of nuts and bolts here on each side, on the bottom. We're gonna remove those, okay? Now, as we're removing those, Robert's gonna tell you about this drain plug and why you wanna remove that. Why do you wanna remove that drain plug, Robert? What will that do if you open that drain plug? That will allow you to get the water out, right?
Yeah, it'll allow you to drain it so you don't have any water shooting up in your nose.
Right, exactly. So basically, before you take, you know, after you obviously disconnect this pump from your pool, you're gonna bring it over to like a workbench or something to rebuild the seal. You're gonna wanna make sure that you remove this drain plug. So Robert, grab a small screwdriver over there, or this screwdriver here. Take out that drain plug and show these folks how that drain plug comes out real quick. So basically just use a little screwdriver there. You can use a pair of pliers if you like to. And just like that, and then water will pour right out of here. So there's your drain plug. Now we're just gonna flip this back the other way just like this, so we can take out these bolts here. Just like this. Now, you know, they might be a little more, if you have a bigger pump, they might be a little harder to take out. You probably won't be able to get them out as fast as I am. But, you know, take your time, it's no rush. I'm just trying to move this along for video purposes. So we have a couple on the bottom here too. Now this is exactly why you wanna make sure the pump has been drained, because if you're flipping it upside down like this, and you are working on a workbench, especially like, you know, a stool in your workshop, he's pretty much soaking wet at this point. You got a little water would fall out. Okay. Now we'll remove this. This is called the volute, the wet end of the pump. We're gonna remove these two bolts from here. Place everything aside. This is where your pump basket is. You wanna also open this up now, take the cover off, make sure this O-ring here, you can take a little flathead screwdriver and pop this little O-ring out here. You wanna make sure this O-ring passes the test, the stretch test. Robert will show you. Stretch your O-ring and make sure it doesn't stretch. Not too much, I mean, you don't want to stretch it all the way out, but if you pull it like this, you know, you're done. So then you wanna pop that back on the cover, just like that. And then you wanna make sure you take out your basket here and clean that. Okay, once you do that, there's also another little O-ring right here. Take a little flathead screwdriver, you can pop this O-ring out. You wanna do the same thing, stretch test. Make sure that O-ring's in good shape, visually inspect it, make sure there's no cracks. Okay, now, here's where we see the impeller. The impeller is right here. This is the eye of the impeller. Water actually gets sucked into this. Basically, if you had this part here, water would get sucked in through the pump, get strained through the strainer basket, which is here, go in through the pump, and then get sucked in through the eye of the impeller right here, just like that. And then once it gets sucked in, it would spin around and shoot out the discharge. So what we're gonna do is here's a little cap on the back of your pump. You're gonna take a little small flathead screwdriver. You're gonna pop this out just like this. And then what you'll see is there's a little groove that you can stick a big screwdriver in just like this. Okay, so what you wanna do is you wanna stick a screwdriver in like that. Now with the other hand, you wanna grab your impeller. And what you're gonna wanna do is just spin the impeller. Now, this impeller is a little loose today. We got this one off easily, but a lot of times you'll get stuck. So you can do something called an impeller wrench. And there'll be another video showing you how to get off stubborn impellers. Because to get into that now is it's complicated, it takes a few minutes, but basically try to grab it as hard as you can and spin it. Sometimes you'll get lucky and you'll be able to spin it off. So let's just say this one, impeller came off easy, because we'll get another video on how to get off stubborn impellers. But so let's say you spin off your impeller here. So once you spin it off, you'll see here's one part of what they call the mechanical seal on the back. And if you take a little screwdriver here, you can take it under the seal. And what you do is you can pop the seal right off the shaft. See that? So here's one part of your seal. Now, if you're looking for a new seal, this is either a PS201 or PS23, I mean a 2131. We have those in the store. You can look at the video. We'll direct you to where you can get these seals right from us. We'll ship them out to you next day. Not a problem. So that's how you get one part of the seal off. Now, this is the one part of the mechanical seal, okay? This is the spring section. You also have the seat of the seal, which is inside here. If you look in there, you can see that white. Okay, now, in order to get that off, we're going to have to do something called removing the through bolts of the motor. Now, if you look at the back of this motor, there's four bolts that are going to remove this section of the fob housing. So now you have your handy-dandy nut driver, just like this, and you're going to want to unspin these four bolts just like this. So you got four of them. One. Sometimes these bolts are stubborn. If you're working on an old pump, it's not going to be this easy. Let's be real. It's going to be stubborn. You know, you might be saying, you might be swearing at this point, depending, you know, how you handle things. But this is for demonstration purposes. You basically need to get these out. Okay, so you got four of them right here, just like this. Once you take the four off, you will then be able to take off the front. This is called the seal housing. Put them all on the side over here. And now the back of your seal, you can see the back of the seal there, and then the front of your seal. You gently want to take your little screwdriver like this, and you want to just pop out the mechanical seal, the seat of it. Now sometimes it's going to be silicone in there, depending on the age of it. Sometimes if your seal is bad completely, it just might pop out. But there you go, there's the second half there. So basically the way this works, there's two parts here. You have the ceramic disc, and then you have this face here. See how they're really flush? If you look at those real carefully, you can see that these platforms are really flush. So what happens is this seals like this, because basically you have to stop the water that's obviously in here from the impeller. All right, you have all this water that's in here. You have to stop it from going out that hole. So how do you really do it? You know, what you want to basically do is you want to make sure these two things are touching perfectly. See that? So what happens is as this spins, they touch so perfectly and the spring tension stays on there that no water actually ever comes out. So what happens after a while, these go bad. Sometimes what can happen, the pump can run hot and this surface here will, you know, become warped or wear down and won't make that seal anymore. So what you have to do is actually change that. So that's basically how you get the seal out. You know, you take it off this one section here. Now to put it back together is the complete reverse of how we did it. But basically you want to get your new seal, you want to lubricate the inside of here. You want to slip that back inside the impeller, just like that. Then you want to put a little bit of silicone on the outside edge of this. You want to place it right inside here. Make sure it fits nice and snug inside your seal housing. Make sure that's snug. So then what you would do, I like to do things simple, so I always like to put a couple of my through bolts right through this motor here before I put my housing back on. That way, at least, you know, I know that all the bolts are. Basically, you want to remember what position we're in. Okay, remember some pumps have the side discharge, some pumps have the top. So you want to make sure you have it the right way when you took it off. You want to make sure you line your through bolts up with the little brass inserts on the back of the seal housing here, like so. And to do so, you can take your nut driver right like this. Probably get out the through bolt. Sometimes you have a little bit of trouble getting them through, you know? And then, you know, obviously when you're on video, you're like, oh no, I don't want to not get this, you know? Yeah. So they basically just tighten your through bolts up like that. Okay, make sure they're nice and tight. Make sure everything's snug. Okay, what you want to do is take a bigger screwdriver, just make sure your shaft is still spinning freely, which ours is. Take the little cap, place it in the back. Front of your pump, you're just gonna spin your impeller, arms like this. Okay, you wanna leave it a little, one half turn loose, and then just plug it in real quick. That will suck the impeller like that.